I don't know what to really do for the intro of this review, so... Good boys, 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 good boys. I don't know why I'm singing. This is not a musical film. But you know why I'm singing it? Because I'm a good boy. Hey there, everybody. This is 22 Tiger Dude here, and I am here to review Good Boys. So Good Boys is directed by Gene Stupnitsky. This is his directorial debut, and it is also written by Gene, as well as his writing partner, Lee Eisenberg, and the film stars Jacob Tremblay, Keith L. Williams, and Brady Noon. So Good Boys tells the story of Max, Lucas, and Thor, these three sixth graders that ditch school and go out there and embark on this journey. However, along the way, chaos ensues. They're accidentally carrying drugs, and they have to get back home on time so they can go to this party. So I was very, very excited for Good Boys. I would say after Booksmart, this was also my most anticipated comedy of the summer. So I was really hoping this would be at least a very good time and not be a disappointment. And I am very happy with what I got with Good Boys, because this did not disappoint. Good Boys is a wild, funny, but also a very heartfelt ride. Good Boys, yes, it is a very raunchy movie. Yes, it is kids swearing, and I could see why some people out there are not going to be on board with this and just think, oh, it's just nothing but kids swearing and nothing more than just that. I can totally get that criticism right off the bat. But for me personally, it worked, because the thing about the tweens swearing in this movie, for me personally, did feel natural, considering, let's be honest, kids, they're not G-rated. They do swear. So it is nice to see Good Boys portray that very accurately and execute it with a ton of care, because I do think the way they execute these kids swearing, I do think it is done with care, and it actually feels natural for the context of the story too. For me personally, it really adds to the comedy factor of this movie, and it's what definitely makes this movie work on that factor right there. And that's definitely where I think Lee and Gene succeeded when it came to the screenplay for this film. They really did take advantage of the sixth grade super bad, and I definitely think it worked, honestly. There's just so many moments in Good Boys that just had me dying of laughter because of these boys' reactions. The reactions from these boys is what makes this movie. It's not just the boys too, to be honest. It's even the other side characters. Like, sometimes in comedies, the leads can stand out, and let me just tell you very quick, and I'll get to them a little bit more right now. The leads definitely do stand out, but even the side characters, I feel, even do stand out. Like, there's this police officer that is finding out a lot of stuff about these boys, and he could get them in trouble, but he's just like, I just want to move on with my day. Obviously, it's such a small role, but my God, that police officer had me laughing. I thought he was so funny for that limited amount of screen time. And any of the other side characters that we bump into, they do stand out. They're very memorable, including these two teenage girls that are after the boys. I thought they were actually pretty funny too, and I thought they actually surprisingly stood out. And surprisingly, they have more screen time than you would honestly expect. You would think they would be one of those one and done characters where once you see them, you never really see them again. But no, they actually have a little bit more screen time than you would expect. Maybe the movie could have done maybe a little bit more with them, but overall I was surprised that they were actually in the movie a little more than you would expect, which I actually thought was actually really refreshing. And like I said, the leads do stand out. Jacob Tremblay, Keith L. Williams, and Brady Noon are all absolutely hysterical. hysterical. Obviously, my favorite one is Keith L. Williams. My God, did he have me laughing. Like, pretty much every line he said had me laughing. I seriously thought he was so good, and I can't wait to see him in future movies, as well as Brady Noon as well. I'd be interested to see what else he'd be doing after this movie. But no, all three of the boys, honestly, even with Keith L. Williams still being my favorite, I do think all three of the boys, to be honest, do a really good job in this film. You feel that friendship, you really feel that bond between them, and, you know, since I bring up friendship, that's something that I do have to applaud Good Boys for. It does have a really good message about friendship, being there for your friends, supporting them. And obviously, I won't say where the movie goes necessarily, especially when we get to the third act, but yeah, it just has a very nice message about friendship, and I thought it was executed very well and made the movie very sweet. It's a nice way for us to feel, you know, a little bit of that heart. Not every scene in this movie is just, oh, these boys are into something chaotic. No, there are moments where it's just a genuinely sweet movie, even with all the chaos going on. I also think that this is a very well shot movie. The cinematography, for me at least, didn't feel cheap. I do think it is actually a very well shot movie. I thought it looked very nice indeed. And I think the direction by Gene Stupnitsky is actually pretty good for the most part. I think at times, I'll say that, the direction, maybe it's a little all over the place, I'll say that, but I do think aside from that, it is a very well-directed movie, and this is from the same person that actually wrote Bad Teacher, didn't direct it, but wrote it, and Bad Teacher was, you know, it was okay, and all that, it was whatever, it was fine, but I do think definitely as far as screenwriting goes, this is definitely a much better written screenplay than Bad Teacher, and I thought the pacing for the most part was even really strong here with Good Boys. I think they do a very good job of just keeping the flow of the movie going and going and not really being bored watching it. I did think it was just very nice and very smooth. Now, when it comes to my criticisms with Good Boys, I already said one of them already as far as like the direction, you know, from Gene being a little bit all over the place, because this is a movie where the boys, they are jumping everywhere, and sometimes in the movie structure, it is a little bit all over the place. Like, obviously, I can easily forgive something like that because I'm still really enjoying the ride. I am still laughing my butt off watching this movie. But yeah, I have to admit, in the direction, it is a little bit all over the place for me. Sometimes the humor didn't work. As far as the movie goes, for like maybe the first 10 to 15 minutes, it was maybe a bit rocky. It still had moments where I was laughing for sure, don't get me wrong, but watching like the beginning of the movie, like the first 10-ish, 15-minute-ish of the movie, I was sitting there going, this is maybe a little bit rocky for me. After that, though, I do think the movie eventually finds its footing. And I will say, as far as the third act goes, that is where I did start to feel the pacing of the movie just a little bit. The first two acts, even with the first act being a little rocky for me, like I said, I still thought it was actually very well paced. But then we get to the third act, and while it is cute, that is the point of the movie where it did drag for me just a little bit. But I would say it does make up because the movie does get into more sweeter territory from there on. Like, don't get me wrong, the first two acts, it had its little moments, but the third act is definitely where it gets more sweeter. Overall, Good Boys is a hilarious time at the movies. My crowd at my screening was great. Everyone was laughing, and I definitely think that's what I like about seeing comedies in theaters, is just seeing people react and having fun. I like seeing that when I see comedy movies in theaters. I definitely think they make for some of the most enjoyable experiences. Now, obviously, if you have a crowd that's not laughing at all, that's definitely a different story. But man, when you have that crowd that just looks like they're having a really good time, enjoying themselves, forgetting about their problems, and just laughing, I really enjoy seeing that, and that was definitely the case when I went to my Good Boys screening. And since I know some of you in the comments are probably going to ask me which one I enjoy more, I honestly enjoy this on the same level as Superbad. Like, I think this is just as enjoyable and just as funny as Superbad is. I really do enjoy Good Boys a lot. Definitely one of the funniest movies of the summer, and I'm going to give Good Boys 3 out of 4 stars. So everyone, in the comments down below, let me know what you think of Good Boys, and also, what is your favorite R-rated comedy? I probably have asked that before, but you know, honestly, out of curiosity, what is your favorite R-rated comedy? I'd be very interested to know. And this is 22 Tiger Dude here. Thank you, as always, everyone, for watching. I always very much appreciate your support, and don't forget that I will always be a good boy and have tiger power.